Hi, it's Brian Gregg. Welcome to another RWD screencast. Today we're going to be talking about ES6 and about the arrow functions. The arrow functions being a feature that was added to JavaScript as part of the new ECMAS6 script standards, and something that allows us both to add a little syntactic sugar to our JavaScript applications, as well as affect the scope of the this function from dynamic to a lexical scoping. So let's talk a little bit about what that means. For those of you who have not seen the new ES6 syntax for arrow functions, or sometimes called fat arrow functions, the way that they look is equals. Instead of what we would normally do, we would say function turn one. Instead of this, which is what we would normally define a function, instead we remove the function keyword and replace it with this equal sign and a greater than sign, which we call the fat arrow. And this defines our function, so it's doing exactly the same thing, but with removing the function keyword and just providing a more concise syntax for defining functions. We can pass parameters in here. One, and we can pass multiple parameters in as well. Notice that when we pass a single parameter, we actually don't need the parentheses, we can just pass the parameter name. When we use multiple parameters, we do need to use the parentheses. That's one, two, three. So that takes one and two, adds them together, and returns three. So that gives you a pretty good idea of what the arrow functions look like in ES6. Now, why are they useful to us? Obviously, they're we're put in here for more than just creating a more concise way of writing anonymous functions, although it is nice. What they do is, unlike functions, most functions in JavaScript that change the scope of the this keyword to reference the calling function, which we call dynamic scoping. This is going to actually use lexical scoping, which retains the scope of the top level initiating function. So let's take a look at an example of that. We have here a function called word. Function word is going to take a value of t, and it is going to assign that value t to a variable called text. And it is going to then return a function called translate, which accepts a value of language. And based on which language you pass in there, it is going to return a translation for that language. We've just put in a translation here for Pig Latin, but theoretically we would have multiple languages in here that could be used to translate our text. Now, you'll notice that in the function t, we're using the arrow function syntax, and we are referencing text using the this keyword. And text is actually outside of the scope of that function. But because we're using the fat arrow syntax, and the fat arrow syntax allows us to use lexical scoping, which does not change the scope of the this keyword as you call functions, we can actually reference text from the this keyword. So if we were to say var our text equals word hello, and we said our text.translate, and we passed the language that we wanted to translate to as Pig Latin, would help if I spelled correctly. Our text. All right. And this is different than if we were to use the traditional function syntax, which I'll just show you quickly, where if we were to say t equals function, same thing here, and we did the same thing. It cannot read the property substring of undefined because text is no longer within scope here, because when we called this function, it actually changed the scope of our application, no longer having access to the text variable that was stored in the function outside of the scope of translate. So you can see here how this can be used in a real-world application. Obviously, the arrow function syntax does not replace our traditional function keyword, but it is something that can be used in conjunction with it for allowing us to manage the scope of our application without having to worry about binding functions or doing anything else that is going to require us to enforce lexical scoping. So hopefully this helped clarify the ES6 syntax and gives you a little bit of a better understanding of this arrow function. As always, I appreciate your comments and subscriptions and likes on YouTube, as well as hitting me up with questions on Twitter at ignoredtuition, and I will see you in the next screencast. Thank you. Yeah.